It's 9 in the morning. Happy St. Patty's Day. I'm here with CT. We're going to give you our best speed workout that you can do in about a 10 by 10 space. All right, we're just going to start. If you have a towel, throw it on the ground. We're going to start with some footwork stuff. So CT's going to follow along as we go. We're going to do about 3 different exercises. In between each set, we're going to add some push-ups to it, because why not? So here we go. So the first one, the crossover step. We're going to double tap on the outside. We'll go for about 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and go. So we're just trying to get the heart rate up, get the body moving as fast as we can. Try not to wake up the neighbors, and good, 10 push-ups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we're right back up into the next footwork drill. We're gonna go right leg over and back for about 10 seconds. Go. If you got a timer, follow along. If not, stop when we stop. When I'm rested, you guys can rest. When CT's working, you guys can work. If we're both going, you guys both should be working. Switch. Right after this, we're going to push-ups. 3, 2, 1. Knock out 10. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Next one, 4, 4, back and back. So we're in front and behind. We're going 10 seconds. Going as quick as we can. And good, last 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll save this towel for later. Now that our heart rate's up, we're gonna get stretched out. The main focus of today's speed is gonna be acceleration, but before we do that, we wanna warm up. We're just gonna start with a squat and lunge complex. So we're gonna squat down, step forward, step forward.
Come up on that.
We're gonna do about 30 seconds for you.
You say welcome, man.
So we're just trying to make the best of what we have, and that's gonna be good enough today. This will eventually get boring, but if we do this stuff together, we'll have a lot better workouts. We'll keep our goals in mind, and we'll get after it. Good. Next one, single leg RDL. Hands on our head. We got about 5 each way. Again, just trying to get the body loose. Trying to wake up. If we can keep our heart rate up for 30 minutes, get a little bit quicker, learn something about speed, that's a win. Press that lateral cross behind lunges. 5 each way. Big step sideways through that. Stretch in the side of your hips. The glute medius. Again, all we're trying to do is do something uncomfortable today. Makes you better for tomorrow, regardless of the circumstances. All right, next one, push-up plus hand walk. So we go right down, do one push-up, walk up, jump back, push-up, hand walk, jump back. We'll knock out 5.
14.
All right. So I'm pretty loose. I'm good to go. We're going to start into our speed work. We talked about it. Acceleration is the focus today. We have a couch, and that's all we need. So you guys have probably done our wall drills. You can do the same thing. Me and CT are going to take turns going. When he's going, you should be working. When I'm going, you should be resting. So CT, let's go ahead. Get in our good position. Right here, we're gonna keep that core tight. I'm gonna say draw in, then we'll get that right leg up. He's got dorsiflexion in that toe, pointing that toe to the couch, driving that knee to the chest. Hip, 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 a little quicker. Hip, 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 and hip, 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 and good, and then we'll switch.
Yeah, go ahead. Sit up, and draw in, right knee up, ready, hip.
He's not waiting for this foot to come down before that foot goes. Hip, Alright, so moving on to a two count. Same idea. This time, when I say hit, you're going to take two steps, starting on his right leg, and then on his right leg. Draw in. Good. Right leg up. And hit. 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 And good. We'll do one each leg.
Draw in. Right leg up. And hit. Hit.
Watch CT's shin angles. As we're doing this right, our shin angles are gonna match up as they cross on that switch. Right leg up, left leg up, and hit. Here we go. Hit, 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 and good. One more time with the two.
And draw in. Left knee, ready, hit.
Moving on to a three count. So as we get into the one and the two and the three, all right, our core has to stabilize a little bit more the more movement we have. Thinking about how this applies to acceleration, if I need to put my foot in the ground and go, I want to be automatic with my knee getting up, my toe getting up. I want to be in a good angle to get out. So this is a little bit lower, CT three count, all right, than we typically do wall work, but this would be great out of a 40 start. If this is something that you want to practice, get that 40 time down, get that right leg up, we got a three count. And hit, good, hit, 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 and good. Don't sacrifice knee height, all right, for quickness on this one.
Ready, draw in, right knee, and hit, two, three, hit, 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 hit.
All right, so we're gonna catch our breath, we're gonna move into some 10-second rapid fire. All right, we're gonna do three rounds of this, about 10 seconds in between. Again, technique first, get that knee up, get that toe up, drive back with force. All right, put the force into the ground, like getting off the ground quick. All right, 10 seconds. Good. Draw in, right leg up, and go. Drive the back, three, two, and good. So, the weather's gonna start getting better. So we're gonna start being able to do this outside. Great way to start, do some acceleration on the couch. Go out in your driveway, run some sprints. Whatever you can do, you gotta keep moving and keep working. One more time. Good, draw in, and go. Good, drive back, stay low, core tight. Get those toes up. And good. All right, so we're gonna take a second, we're gonna grab a sip, we're gonna come back, finish up. Water right behind these guys. All right, so we talk about acceleration, talk about being quick off the ground. So now we understand the concept of driving back, being quick. We're gonna take the same thing, we're gonna do it standing up. We're gonna have our rapid fire going, but our hands are gonna be on our head. As we do this, I wanna minimize ground contact. We got two rounds of this, and then we're gonna move into some plyos. All right, some things that we can do to stay explosive, all right, without wavering. Ready, perfect. Hands on head,
one.
So we're going, rapid fire. And right knee up, and go. Three, two, and one. So we'll give it about 10 seconds in between each one of those. As you can tell, we just took ourselves from a stable position to an unstable position. Our core has to do a lot more to work to keep us stabilized. We're going five. We got one more. All right, we got three, two, and go. 5 seconds, let's go. So, moving into plyos, we got a small space. You guys probably have a small space at home. The first one we're gonna start, you'll go, I'll go.
Yep.
We'll go back leg elevated, single leg, jump. We'll go five each leg, We're only gonna go through 2 rounds of each drill. Show you guys a lot to work with. All right, if you're at home, don't put your shoes on the couch. Your mom will get mad at you. Get that back leg up. Good, and go. Good, 5 each. Good. Being explosive, getting that knee up. Good. Stay with it. There we go. Good. Hey, we're about 15 minutes in. All right, we're sweating. This is hard?
Yes.
All right, so we don't need anything. All right, get better today. All right, we've got about 15 hard minutes left. All right, we're gonna keep going with some plyos, moving to some core, and obviously we gotta finish with some push-ups.
Obviously.
And it's almost beach season. Right around the corner.
It's almost Cedar Point season.
Oh, I can't get on the rise. Too short.
All right. Personal shot.
Yeah. So, next one, again, bringing together some of that single leg stuff we just did. And we're just gonna go back and forth.
Yep.
Stagger stand, broad jump. I'm gonna stagger my feet. I'm gonna go heel toe. I'm gonna jump off of both feet at the same time. I'm gonna land on both feet together. So I'm gonna go up, jump, stick that landing, and I'm gonna hit it. Going back.
You can go back this way, I want to jump on the screen.
Okay. Watch out, there's couches. Good. We got three each leg. We'll rest and we'll do it again. After three, switch your feet. Taking all that single leg stuff, putting it together. We got some double leg bound. We're gonna do it with a drop squat. So we always talk about getting off the ground. The right way to do that is by setting your jump up with a drop squat. So I'm just gonna hit the ground and get off as quick as I can. Just like that, we got two sets of five.
Slight landing.
Keeping that core tight, driving those knees to the chin. If you're not sweating at this point, you work off a month. We need 5 seconds. Hang in there. And you get it. All right, next one's a bird dog. So we're gonna show you this one sideways. See if you can stay together. As I do this, I'm gonna be in a good bear crawl position. All right, I'm gonna have my right arm reach out. I'm gonna tuck my core. I don't wanna arch my back. I'm gonna keep it, legs around it right here. Brace my core, pull my belly button into my back. And we're just gonna go reaching out, touching back in, 10 each side. Nice and controlled, dorsiflex in the back, keeping that stability. Reaching back with the arm, reaching back with that heel. Good. After 10, we're gonna go ahead and switch. Squeezing that glute in the back, reaching our body. Get as long as we can. Keep it real simple. We're gonna go as fast as we can through these exercises. We have 21 push-ups, V-ups, squats. Right into 15 push-ups, V-ups, and squats. Right into 9 push-ups, V-ups, and squats.
V-ups are no joke now.
All right, now, just to demo all those exercises real quick. You should see that right there? That's still on you. Just to demo it, all right? We wanna make sure all our reps are good reps. So our push-ups, we start in a lockout position. All the way down, all the way up to lockout. For our V-ups, we're going to be on our back. Our feet are going to stay in the air. We have to get our shoulders off the ground for the rep to count. We have to touch our toes for the rep to count. That might mean we need to break some of these reps up. All right, that's okay. Just make sure we do them all, get them all right. then our squat, bodyweight squat, heels down, toes slightly out. All right, we're gonna drop the leg to squat, and then stand back up. Our butt has to go below our knees. All right, we're gonna give it about 20 seconds, me and CT, to catch our breath. We'll start at the top of 26.
Cool, I feel those feels.
All right, get ready. Start in 3, 2, 1, and go.
No, you can't see it. All the other coaches are doing it behind the scenes. Everybody's here working hard.
Eric and Stevie, I'm out of breath, right behind us on the keyboard. Let us know. If
James.
Not, we'll ramble.
Coach James, I have a question.
What's up, Jess?
I see your shirt says T3 Barbell.
Yeah, buddy.
What is T3 Barbell?
So, T3 Barbell is our Olympic weightlifting team. It's a group of about 15 of us. It started about 3 years ago, mostly a youth program, teaching young kids how to move a barbell. It's a skill hopefully they'll use the rest of their life. And right now we have more of a adult competitive team. About 2 weeks ago, we were at the Arnold, had a great time, lifted a lot of weight, had a blast. Whew. All right, so the first thing I want to talk about is keep to your routines. And this is a big thing for me, for any of us, as we go forward, is we need to schedule out our time to make sure we use this as the most productive time period as we can. If you want to think about it, especially with school being online, there's going to be a lot of excuses and a lot of reasons for distraction. But you can look at the next day, you can look at the next week, and you can plan. We might not know what's going to happen 5 to 8 weeks from now, but we know tomorrow we're going to have to wake up. We're going to have to sweat. We're going to have to work out. If we want to keep all our goals that we have, you know, 1 year from now, 2 years from now, we got to stay active. And for me, being in a routine is the best way to do that. So schedule when you're going to do your classes. Schedule when you're going to get your training session. We're trying to make it easy for you that worst case scenario, you get a half hour with us in the morning at 9, and then you can go about your day. But there's more than you can do than just this. So CT is going to talk about some other bodyweight exercises, some ways to get creative and use the things around you.
Yeah, so, you know, we like to come in here and load up a barbell. We like to grab a heavy kettlebell, dumbbells, things like that. A lot of us don't have options like that at home, right? You don't have dumbbells sitting around, kettlebells sitting around. What you can do, and what you might have done in the past, maybe on times of traveling, or trips, things like that, is get a bag of yours that you can hold in both hands, put some clothes in there, put some shoes, put some heavier things, and you can do a lot with just a bag, right? You can YouTube exercises that you can do, but you can also, we all know squats, we all know lunges, we all know different lunge variations, we all know push variations, we all know pull variations, right? We can do those things with bags, grocery bags, right, that are heavy, travel bags that are heavy, you do them with suitcases, things like that, right? Get really creative. Go outside, put a heavy backpack on, do some lunging outside, go on a long walk, do things like that now, especially because it's getting nice out, right? We have a lot of good places around the area to be able to walk and enjoy the weather. Go do that, get some fresh air, get off the couch, stop playing the games, stop watching, you know, Netflix for an extended amount of time, and get out and do something and sweat, like he said. Be uncomfortable every once in a while, once a day if you can, is the goal.
And hey, this is going to be a lot harder a week from now, right? It's going to get boring. It's going to get to be something that, you know, we don't look forward to every day. It's not new. It's not fancy or creative, all right? So find somebody to hold you accountable and hold them accountable. You know, you have teammates out there. Most of you guys listening, watching us, you know, hopefully you're athletes of us that we've trained, maybe some new people tuning in too, all right? But do this with a teammate. Doesn't mean you have to be in the same room, all right? But check in on them. Shoot them a text at 8:50. Hey, man, you tuning in. Do it with somebody, all right? Hold each other accountable, all right? And then, you know, no matter what happens, we'll be able to move around, we'll be able to sweat, we'll be able to stretch, all right? We have a lot of options, all right, based on the restrictions that we have, all right? So just because there's restrictions doesn't mean we can't be creative, all right, and still work towards our goals.
And the other thing I'll say about that is don't wait till 9:30 at night, right? Don't wait till 8:30 at night. Don't push it off till after dinner. Do it if you can first thing in the morning when you get up. Like we said, we'll be here 30 minutes at a time. We'll have different coaches, different training sessions that you can do. Try to get it done out of the way and set the tone for the day and make sure the day is great.
So I got Noah Henry from BW.
Yeah, what's up, Noah?
What's up, Noah?
He's been tuning in all day.
Oh, yeah.
So he says, one, he appreciates you guys through your little what's up. And he says, what does the 10 a.m. athlete group entail?
So today at 9, obviously, like, we do a lot more speed work. All right, so Coach Ryan, who's standing right there, all right, he's going to be doing more of a bodyweight strength circuit. So he's going to incorporate some creative ways, all right, to, again, use a living room to do a strength workout. So, you know, more of a burn, more of a pump kind of stuff for the quads, the upper body. All right, again, getting creative with how to use the body as a tool to keep us strong. Does that sound about?
That's correct.
Sweet.
We got Max Seipel tuned in. You want to say anything to Max?
Yeah, Max.
No, Max is doing this at home.
Yeah.
You know that's what he's doing. If I know Max.
Max is doing
this. I know he's at home. He's at home doing this. Training.
All right. Well, until tomorrow, we're out.
Nice.
Woo. I'm out of shape.
Right.